Why do I think my beats are so addictive? Wow, I never thought they were addictive, but must be, because a lot of people are mimicking it now. They don't even call me, they just make a clone. But that's what lawyers are for. Hey, I'm Pierre Bourne, and Esquire has asked me to talk about some things about my life and career. Let's dive in, shall we? What artist inspired you the most growing up? 50 Cent, he's from my neighborhood, Southside, Jamaica, Queens. Kanye West as a producer and artist. And Lil Bow Wow when I was a little kid and wanted to rap. There's a lot of artists that inspired me, but those are like the three that kind of like still are a part of my like story now.
What is the origin story of your producer tag?
To be honest, I was just watching TV with my little brother. The TV said it. It's a lot of shows that say Pierre.
Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
They said Pierre on The Proud Family. They said Pierre on Hey Arnold. They said Pierre on Sabrina the Teenage Witch. They said Pierre on Kenan and Kel. They said Pierre on Bob's Burger. Pierre's like the most generic French name for film, I think. I don't know. They just don't pick anything else, I guess. There's actually two Yo Pierres. Like, there's another Yo Pierre on Martin, on the TV show Martin. Martin's TV show, Martin Lawrence. He says, "Yo, yo, Pierre, come now." Because he was talking to another waiter. So it's like, who's writing these scripts? Shout out to them. Whoever wrote the script, man, they changed my life. Can you break down how you made the beat for Lil Uzi's Bean Kobe? We actually did this on my birthday. It might have been 2017. I told Uzi my birthday was coming up, and he was like, "Yeah, we gonna hang out." And, you know, I'm thinking everybody's just saying that. And this guy pulled up to my hotel, 3 or 4 cars, like foreigns. And I'm just like, what's going on? Like, why are you doing this? Like, I was so new to everything. I'm just like, all right, I'm just going with the flow, but hey, this is gonna be a good birthday. We get in the car, and he's like, "Yeah, we're gonna pull up on Chief Keef." I'm like, "Sosa?" He like, "Yeah." I'm like, "Oh, steak keeps getting better and better." So we pull up on Sosa. He gets in the car with us, and then we go to the studio, and then we're in the studio. It's me, Uzi, Chief Keef, and we're just vibing. I'm playing beats, and they did a bunch of songs, like a bunch of songs. And then they made the Kobe, the Bean Kobe, like, rest in peace, Kobe, first and foremost. It was just a vibe. It was my birthday. I had all these famous people around me. It was just cool. It was just like, dang, all right, I made it. It just felt like I made it. Pierre Bourne's 10 best beats. What are your personal favorite top 3 beats? What are my favorite? I want to say one for sure is Hell Shell, Young Nudie on Nudie Land. And Yeah Yeah by Young Nudie. Half of the beats I rapped on, I'm like torn between, like, I miss my song. And then there's one I know I gave to Cardi, Magnolia. I gotta say Magnolia, it changed my life. Yeah, when that song came out, I moved to LA, met Kanye, worked with Drake, I got a Grammy. It's a lot, bro. Like, it's a lot. I made that beat in my best friend's car. And I'm really thinking about doing something like that again. Just getting in the car, making beats in the car. I just want to go back to that a couple times, you know? I really had to take this picture, man. I had to. What did you learn most from collaborating with Kanye?
I think what I learned while being around Kanye was just to, like, prepare for what's next for me. Not saying that I'm trying to be him, but if history is repeating itself, we might want to pay attention to the history and learn from it so I can kind of steer it the way I want to go.
Oh man, this is like a behind the scenes shot for my album cover for The Life of Pierre 5. It'll be releasing soon, probably in June. Came to New York and we had to get up like 8 in the morning on Sunday. I'm walking onto this boat and they have all my pillows from home on the boat. I'm just like, we're really doing it. Explain your relationship with Pokemon. With Pokemon, like, I love Pokemon since I was a kid. I had the Game Boy before the color, and I had the Game Boy Color. One of my uncles, he actually had the Japanese green version when I was a little kid.
We were super into Pokemon, the Pokemon cards. I wanted to be Ash. He was throwing those Pokeballs, catching them Pokemon. He was beating them trainers, and he became the best. So, I mean, that inspired me. The magic in Pierre Bourne's production comes from taking sounds that are magic. I don't really look at my production like how everyone else looks at it. I just make a couple beats. I mean, I'm grateful for everything, like, but I used to rap, so the beats part is like amazing. The ones people are cheering me on for, I can do that in maybe an hour. Where my family comes from, we're from Belize. The soca music, like all of that is definitely influenced into my production because it's in my bloodline, it's in my blood. Other than that though, I can't really say, hey, this is where it originates from, because honestly, I don't even know sometimes.
One of my childhood friends didn't even know I was Pierre. Like, we just linked this year.
Wow.
And he was like, yo, bro, I didn't know that was you. And I was just like, you got to stay out of jail.
Nah, man. I think I was really nervous that day, too. There was a lot of lights. But I do laugh like that. I definitely laugh like that. Sometimes I would laugh like SpongeBob. It all depends on the seriousness and how funny it is and who's around me. It was funny, so it was like, damn. So it was like, like one of those, like a sprinkler system.
First of all, for more than one reason.
Yo, yo, I put some ice on her hand. I let it take in advance.
Can you break down how you made the beat for Drake's Pain 1993? To be honest, I didn't expect Drake to get on this song. So it wasn't like I made the beat and it was like, all right, Drake, here you go. When it was coming about, I was just excited. When I heard the song, I was just like, wow, we finally got Drake on my beat. But we went on tour together like 2017. We talk all the time. I just sent him like some of my songs for my album. Like, we always stay in touch. Is Papoose really your cousin? Why don't nobody believe me, man? Man, he like my distant cousin. He's my cousin's cousin. Did he influence you at all growing up? I've never met him. I was supposed to go to one of his video shoots growing up, but it was like an all white thing and I didn't have all white. So I think that was like the day where I was like, yeah, I'm good. I don't have to meet him. I'm gonna make it. Like, I don't need to meet him to make it.
What's your best piece of advice for young wannabe rappers?
My best advice, which sounds pretty cliche, is just to keep faith. Anyone can say, oh, do this, do that. But there's so many things that can make you lose your confidence. So as long as you keep your faith through whatever you're trying to do, I mean, you'll be all right. Yo, I'm finished. Yo, Pierre, I came out here. I just want to say thank you guys for watching. My album's coming out soon, The Life of Pierre 5. Sauce Boy featuring Uzi's coming out. Okay, so just stay tuned. Got a lot more music coming out. Thanks for watching. See you guys later. Peace.